What if I told you all that I found a way to export out videos from Premiere Pro 5 to 10 times faster? Well, that's what I'm gonna be doing in today's tutorial, showing you smart rendering so that you can export out your next video 5 to 10 times faster. Let's go ahead and show you all how to do that.
Okay guys, so now that we're inside of Premiere Pro, for this tutorial I'm gonna be using the intro that you just watched. Now this video doesn't have any heavy effects or a lot of layer comps on it. It does, however, have an adjustment layer with Lumetri Color that I did use for the color correction color grade of this video. So for this, we're going to export out two different versions of the same video. The first will be the normal rendering and the second being the smart rendering. Now both sequences have been rendered out, as you can tell from the in and out points. So they both are rendered out and ready to be exported out. So let's go ahead and export out the first version, which is going to be the normal rendering. We're going to head over to File, Export, Media, or Command M for short. Click Media. Once we have this opened and up, we're going to go over to the format. And instead of picking H.264 like I know a lot of you do, we're going to click QuickTime. And under Preset, we're going to pick Apple ProRes 422 HQ. Now I know we're all familiar with YouTube's recommended suggestion of exporting out your project as an H.264 file for upload. However, if you go to their YouTube help section and browse their supported upload formats, you'll actually see that it does support much more than just H.264, also known as an MP4 file. So I'll leave a link down below where you can view the codec formats that YouTube does allow. And while you're browsing down, you will see that they do offer the ProRes option as being able to be uploaded to their YouTube site. So with that being said, let's go ahead and scroll down to the video tab. We see that the video codec is in Apple ProRes 422 HQ. The match source is set correctly at the 3840 by 2160, which is the UHD setting. The frame rate is 23.976, field order progressive, aspect square pixels. Now for the render at maximum depth, I do choose to select this and I have it at the 8 bits per channel. Now for the render at maximum depth, I do choose to select this because it does render your content at 32-bit color. Now I do know that most output formats don't support 32-bit color, but what it does is it processes this video at the 32-bit color depth so it can produce better quality. Say for instance, if you had a lot of compositing or effects, color grade, transitions, anything like that, and then it scales it back to the output format's bit depth that you're going to be uploading at. Now, as I said, if you're somebody who's doing a lot of compositing, effects, transitions, color grades, etc., this is something that I would utilize, and I choose to usually do this even for a simple YouTube video because I'm shooting in GH5 or CineStyle and I want the best possible color depth for my videos. And rendering at the maximum depth can also reduce or eliminate your artifacts and banding in your video. But as it did say, it does come at a cost of increasing your export time a little bit. So with that being said, let's scroll down. Everything else is going to stay the same. Let's head over to the audio tab. The codec is uncompressed. The audio settings is 48 Hertz sample rate at 16 bit. Whoop, let's put it back to 48. And it is in stereo. So let's go back to the video tab. Everything is good there. Now the use maximum render quality box, I'm not going to be checking. The only other box that I will be checking is the use previews. Now the reason why I'm not going to select use maximum render quality is because the only time you want to select that is when you're outputting to a different frame size from your sequence. So everything matches up from my sequence to my output settings. Now the last thing we need to do is come over to the output name and I'm going to put it on my desktop. I'm going to change this to non-smart render, no spaces, hit save. Yes, I want to replace. And now it is good to export. Now as you all can see, the smart render was 9 times faster than the normal render. So the way we're able to actually speed up this export is by using smart render. So the way that you accomplish this is first make sure that you have the correct sequence that you want to do the smart render to. We'll double click this. That is the correct one. You're going to go up to sequence, and select Sequence Settings. You're going to change the editing mode to custom if it isn't already in custom, time-based 23.976, and it should already match everything that is already in your sequence. The frame size is correct, the pixel aspect ratio is the same, fields the same, display format is the same. Now, this is where you're going to speed up your export time. We're going to go down to Video Previews, and instead of the iframe only MPEG that it leaves standard with Premiere Pro when you create a new sequence, we're going to change this to QuickTime and change the codec to Apple ProRes 422 HQ. We'll then hit reset and it should change to your above sequence setting dimensions, which it did. We'll leave everything else the same. We're going to go over and now click OK, where we'll now get a message telling us if we change the preview file format or the frame size, it will delete all other previews before it. You want to click OK. And as you can see now, it's gone to yellow from being green, meaning we will now need to render out these new preview settings from the in and out settings that you have on your sequence. Go ahead and render it into out. I actually have a keyboard shortcut set up for rendering into out. I'm going to let that render into out real quick. Now your sequence has been rendered and the preview files are going to match the same settings we'll be using to export the video as. So now we can export out this new version. So what we're going to do is we're going to hit Command M, which is our export shortcut. And now all you have to do is click Match Sequence Settings. And the export now will match the sequence settings we've just set up. Now I always double check to make sure everything is correct. We're going to scroll down. Video codec is correct. The width and height is correct, 3840 by 2160. Frame rate is correct. Field order is correct. Aspect is correct. The rendered maximum depth that I talked about earlier, that's a preference. You don't have to do that. However, it is something that I choose to do because I wanted to make sure that it goes through the 32-bit color depth for any color grades that I do or transitions or any heavy compositing that I do. Now, keep in mind, if you do click this in the export, you're not going to be able to do the match sequence settings. So it's just a preference on if you want to use that or not. Everything else is the same. We'll go over and check the audio. Uncompressed, 48 hertz, 16-bit, stereo. Okay, everything's correct. Now all you have to do is come down and click Use Previews. So now because we did the smart render, which was matching our sequence settings to the export settings that we plan on doing, once you use the Use Previews, Premiere Pro is now going back and looking at the preview files that you rendered out and using that to export out your final project. So because the sequence setting matches the export setting, now there's no more compression or rendering that needs to be done. So once you hit this export, now it's going to do a smart render export and it's going to be so much quicker once you export this project. So go ahead and make sure real quick too that the output is in the correct file that you want it as. I'm going to change this to non-smart render final, save, and hit export. And as you can see, it's so much quicker than the non-smart render, normal render that we saw earlier. And it's done. So guys, the other amazing thing with smart rendering besides the export time is say you're doing a project for a client and they need an edit revisement. Well, now you can come back into your sequence and change the edit that the client gave you in the notes. And it's only going to affect that specific clip or part of the sequence that you're changing. So for instance, maybe the client wanted this first part of the clip to be scaled in more. So let's add an effect right there, scale it in. And as you can see now, it's only affecting this specific clip and not the whole sequence. So all you would have to do is render out that new edit and then export out the project again, and it's going to take the same amount of time. So that's another amazing thing with smart rendering. So guys, that's how we use smart render and your preview files to be able to speed up your export time by at least 5 times.
If you found this video helpful and you want to see more content like this on my channel, like, comment, and share this video, as well as subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't already.